Welcome to Zimist Coded, your ultimate destination for straightforward and practical tutorials on Microsoft Office and various IT-related topics. In today's video, we will demonstrate how to insert a table of contents in Microsoft Word using a sample document. A table of contents is an excellent tool for organizing your document, making it easier for readers to navigate through sections and subsections. Let's get started. Here is our sample document. You can observe that it contains multiple headings and subheadings. These titles and subtitles represent the various sections and subsections, or chapters and subchapters, of our document. In our document, the block titles are the main headings, while the bold italicized titles are the subheadings. We aim to insert a table of contents right after the cover page. To create a table of contents, we first need to apply heading styles to the titles and headings in our document. Heading styles enable Word to recognize the different levels of headings within your document. We will apply Heading 1 to the main headings and Heading 2 to the subheadings. First, select the heading title you want to format. Then, click the desired heading style in the Styles gallery on the Home tab. Section or chapter headings typically use the Heading 1 style, so we'll apply this to all section headings. First level subsection headings generally use the Heading 2 style, so we'll apply this to all subchapter headings. Follow along as I apply Heading 1 and Heading 2 to the main and subheadings, respectively. Once we've applied the heading styles, we can proceed to insert the table of contents. To do this, navigate to the page where you want to insert the table of contents and click at the beginning of the page. Next, go to the References tab on the ribbon and click the Table of Contents button. A menu of different table of contents styles will appear. You can choose from several styles. Click the style you want to use, and the table of contents will be inserted into your document. If you make any changes to your document that affect the table of contents, such as adding or removing headings or changing page numbers, you'll need to update it. To update the table of contents, right-click it and select Update Field. A menu of options will appear. Choose the option that corresponds to the changes you've made, and the table of contents will be updated automatically. You can also customize the style of the multi-level list for headings and subheadings. To add numbering and subnumbering to them, first click on the section to select it. Then go to the Home tab and in the Paragraph section, click on Multi-Level List. From the list, select a style that includes headings, chapters, or articles. For this tutorial, we'll select a style that best fits our document structure. Now, you can see that the multi-level list has been applied to our headings and subheadings. Let's update the table of contents to reflect these changes. You will now see the updated headings and subheadings in the table of contents. That's it for this tutorial. You've learned how to apply heading styles, insert a table of contents, update it, and add a multi-level list to your document. I hope you found this video helpful. Don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, and share this video. Your support helps us create more content like this. Thanks for watching Zimist Coded, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.